This just came through from a friend. Breaking. Official statement from director of Al-Shifa hospital in Gaza. The conditions are tragic and those in the hospital are screaming from thirst. We cannot even take out the garbage from inside the hospital. Israeli sniping operations continue. No one can move from one building to another, and we have lost communication with all our colleagues. Israeli drones do not stop flying over the hospital. There are Israeli recruits roaming the departments, especially the emergency department, and they pulled out the bodies. We buried about 80 bodies, and the rest of the bodies that were in the streets or in refrigerators are removed by the occupation. There are bodies still inside the departments, and we want to move them to avoid health disaster occurring inside the hospital. There are 4 dialysis patients in the final crisis now due to the lack of services. The hospital has completely run out of oxygen and conditions are very difficult and disastrous. The Israeli occupation stories about weapons entering the hospital or the MRI department are false. Let's go back to the 15th of November, that's day 39 of Al Nakba. Al Jazeera just played an extraordinary recording of a phone call earlier tonight between Dr. Munir Al-Bash inside the Shifa hospital and the Israeli army as the Israelis informed him of their intention to raid the hospital. The doctor tells Israeli soldier Al-Shifa hospital is full of people on all 6 floors. He warns him of freshly dug graves on the right side of the hospital courtyard. The soldier asks why they dug the grave there and is told there were too many dead bodies in the hospital that were decomposing. The soldier tells the doctor, be careful. The doctor says, be careful from what? The soldier says, just be careful. The doctor says, I'm among all the people trapped here. What are you planning to do? Then the doctor says to the soldier, the maternity ward and administration sections are empty, but the burn unit and other sections are filled with people. Missed from the beginning of this call, the doctor tells the soldier, people have been terrified since they heard you were coming. People are really scared in here. As a former medical student, I can barely imagine what was happening while this was going on. I know that in Brisbane here and on the Gold Coast, Justice for Palestine has been organising around a variety of different themes, and for the rally on this coming Sunday at 2 p.m. in Queen's Park on the corner of Elizabeth and George Street, the theme is the health system. I'm hoping people can attend. There's a public meeting coming up next Wednesday at the Queensland Council of Unions. And there's a rally today, I think at 2 p.m. on the foreshore at Surface Paradise. If you look up the Justice for Palestine Mianjin website, you'll be able to see the details of these and other events. Please try to do whatever you can to tell your friends about what is happening and give them some understanding of the crisis that we are engaged in. I want to make a direct call to the Minister for Health, the Minister for Foreign Affairs, the Minister for Defence, and the Prime Minister, Albanese. If you have any complicity in this, if you are providing any kind of weapons through the 320 secret contracts that you have with Israel, the lives of these people are on your hands. Anyway, Ian Kerr, 4PR, Voice of the People, signing off here from Brisbane.